Hello everybody, welcome back to Mecha Will Plays Bloodborne. I'm gonna be real with you guys. Well, excuse me. Give me 1 second here. That is probably agreeable. Okay, I'm gonna be real with you guys. I don't remember where we last left off. It's been a few more days. I'm still struggling to get into a little bit of a routine with some of my options here. But it looks like maybe we just met one of these NPCs here, which is pretty sweet. What's up, girl? Okay, what can I do for you?
Curses. A night to remember.
A night to remember. I definitely say so. Can you maybe tell me the right direction or way to go? No? Okay, well, it was worth a shot at the very least. Let me, let's take care of these guys here. Let's get back into the groove of combat. So, guys, recall we're on a little bit of a mission to the Healing Church. I imagine. But this is the frantic game that basically makes you shit your pants every time you play it. I gotta keep that in mind. There we are. Nope, we're in a bad spot. We're in a bad spot. Excuse me. Okay. This is what you guys come for. This is the fucking gripping action. And missing shots, of course. Oh my god, these guys are just the simplest of enemies. How are you ever going to beat a boss? You can't beat a few of these guys. I'm very happy that they're starting us off with blood vials already. But, and the second thing I'm also super happy about is it appears that we are going in the right direction. It's been such a long time since I've gotten to play a new Souls game. I'm super excited for the Dark Souls 3 DLC that's coming out too, but let's dig into the gothic Victorian horror vibe of... Oh my god. I didn't ask for this life. I didn't want this. I didn't need this. Excuse me, sir. What can I do for you? You're carrying a large sack. I don't know, you gotta go about your day job, and I gotta go about my day job. So I'm not even gonna ask you about it. I'm not even gonna ask you what that thing was all about. But I gotta tell you, I'm not a big fan of it. Something tells me we should be in Perry City with this guy. Let's do our best to do so. No? That's not a parry window? There we are. Oh, what? Just because his back was turned, you don't give me a parry? I think you're full of shit. Honestly, do. Don't question the game. Just be better. No? Come on. Let me try one more. That was definitely a thing. Also, this guy hurts like a bitch. Maybe we should stop fucking with the parries. I mean, it appears to me that the one thing that I've really been not great about in this game is parrying. And maybe that's just the key to the kingdom that I'm not aware of. Did I just die in one hit? I guess that's why you don't want to get hit by the sack. Okay. Now the scary part of trying to get back to where I was before. Oh, Bloodborne, you're starting me off. You're starting my day off just perfect. Just beautiful enough. Sinister Resonance, but I believe it's probably like the red soapstone. Excuse me? What did I do? I don't understand. I was never meant to die like this. It wasn't supposed to be like... Oh, the Sackman, is he supposed to kill? I don't understand. Maybe I fucked something up, dude. But Sackman took me to his fucking sack lair. We're in Sack Dungeon right now. Dude, this feels creepily like the Seath's Dungeon in the first game. So if there's a sleeping guard or something equally, excuse me? Yahar Ghul Unseen Village. Holy fuck. Well, we found ourselves at least in a new location, so... New location, same old pots, baby. We gotta find some familiar things at least. Also, I have yet, I believe, to find a secret wall. I have no idea if they exist or not, but they gotta. They just gotta. Is this the... What is this? Okay, I thought that was the guard that was gonna let me out. Well, you know, maybe if you were just trying to open in the door, maybe you should consider that. There's a dude in a chair. I almost want to go back in the cell and never speak of this place again. I feel scared. Hello, fine sir. What may I do for you today? Just stand in your cold embrace? No, is that not gonna work either? Is this a boss battle? This looks like a boss chamber or something. There's a lot of these creepy lampshades around. Oh yeah, baby, get some thick cold blood. That fucking V8 juice. Madman toil syrup. This is gonna read like nonsense. Madmen toil surreptitiously in rituals to beckon the moon. Uncover their secrets. I'll do my best. That's the whole point of me being here. Well, it seems to me like that might be the way to uncover said secrets, but I'm not quite done exploring this side. What do we got over here? Anything juicy? I just want to fight people, goddammit. I just want to hold you close. Feel your heart so close to mine. And I'll stay here in this moment. That looks like a big guy. Oh shit, there's more sack people. The sack people are the jail guards. Well, there was no bonfire, but we still come on. I disagree with the timing on that, but maybe I just don't understand. At least we got a little health back. Excuse me? That's an AoE that reached down the stairs. We're kind of fucked. Well, since my wonderful... Thank you. Thank you for being the right man for me. Oh, not okay with that. He's gonna try and grab me. I'm not a fan of the grab. Excuse me. What did I ever do to you? He's trying to do something. Let me help you boys out, okay? Let me take you to Mecha Wheeltown and show you how we do it here. We nearly get fucking crushed by one. Nope. Move back. Get that stamina back up. These guys, you are so dumb. For real, you are so dumb. I hate being a little cheesy with this. These guys hurt like an absolute BS. Nope. I probably deserve to get hit by the sack there, but I did not. So let's try and stay as best we can. Hold on. No, we want the range here. Right? Let's be real. Is that it? The keys to the kingdom. Have you dropped them? No, we got some bloodstone shards though. This seems like a fairly difficult area, but honestly, that seems like every single area in Bloodborne. Where am I? Am I in? That's some creepy ass shit up there. The music is creepy. Everything. I've been playing Resident Evil 7 and I'm freaked out of my mind. Out of my goddamn mind. Oh. Are we in the Church of Healing? Because this is not what I imagined. I imagined a much brighter place with less creepy individuals staring down at me. Hello. Is it me you're looking for? I can see it in your eyes. Dude, I fucking love that we got a lamp. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we found our new home. I'm not very happy about it, I'll be real with you. But, that guy has got to go. I'm sorry, dude, you've got to go. I can't play this game with you standing over me like that. It's not fair. It's not fair! Ah! Yeah, we gotta keep an eye out for some shortcuts, too, because that's definitely something I'm looking for. Nightmarish rituals crave a newborn. Find one and silence its heroic cry. Alright, guys, we're out to slaughter a baby. Nothing weird about that. It's just, you know, it's what happens in the Bloodborne domain. We just, you know, it's perfectly natural. Any babies down here that we can... Wow, this is like a fucking maze down there. Labyrinth. Oh, also, we got Moon. Whatever that means. This looks like a fairly fucked up dead dude. Let's see what he was hiding. What's up with you, man? Moon. Excuse me? Is Moon armor? Nah. Moon rune. Acquire more blood echoes. Okay. It's another rune. So we can use this, I guess, to boost some of our stats, maybe in one of our weapons if we do some crafting, which I believe is how that works. I also got turned around there for a minute. That's how new I am to this location. I just don't understand where to go. Trust me, boys. I'm sure we'll get better with age, like a fine wine. I'm gonna give you two of those, and I'm gonna let you do your thing, and then I'm gonna use one. Is that valid? We did find a pebble. The greatest gift ever given to us in this scary-ass temple. Oh, we're underneath the bridge. We see the outside of our favorite locale. I hear somebody coming towards me. Well, maybe, like, wait. See? I'm so scared. You guys don't understand. Where is it? It's there! It's fucking Hogman. Well, hopefully we can... Can I sneak by Hogman? No, Hogman sees me. What can I do, dude? You get... Oh, shit. You get close to me like that again, I will fucking chop you up and put you in a can of Chef Boyardee soup. You deserve it. I can... Oh, no. Don't get close. You're better than that. Nah, we're not better than that. Nah, now he's coming. He's gonna cheese him. Now he's coming for us. We don't have anything here to purge the thing? Are we just out of, oh no, there we are. It might be like, well, it might be a good idea to, excuse me? Sort, select, okay, blah, blah, blah. I don't know how to put it on my bar. That's not good. We're just gonna have to deal. I'm sorry, I gotta apologize. Hogman. Alright, this is our golden opportunity. We found our moment. Is that another hog down there? It can't be. And what's down here? Oh, we've got goodies, dude. And I'll stay in this moment for all the rest of time. I just wanna hold you close. I feel your heart's close to mine. Alright. Don't wanna miss a thing. Cause even when I dream of you, these dreams will never do. I still miss you, baby. And I don't wanna miss a thing. How do I close my eyes? Yeah, I don't wanna fall asleep, babe. Alright, let's enough of that. For sure. We've overstayed our welcome in the Aerosmith universe. Honestly, this guy's overstayed his welcome in my universe. Boom. Roasted. Let's see if maybe we can, God damn, the choirs. It's probably fucking drowning out my voice, right? It's probably not, actually, but just the volume's just to the right, just the right temperature, just the right fucking temperature. I'm very happy to be getting more goodies, though. What do we got here? Frenzied cold blood. So we're just picking up all the right stuff. All of this stuff should definitely help us upgrade our weapons and level up, which I feel like is maybe stuff that we should do fairly soon. I forget what the barrier was to us leveling this weapon up again, but we were having some trouble with it before. Please don't tell me the other guy that I woefully let back there is going to come back and fuck with us during this situation. Don't cry like that. I'm not crying. There's just an axe in my face. Yeah. And if you see some blood streaks down my cheeks, please, please. What is up with you, dude? Oh my god, I'm getting some real, level 3-1 Tower of Latria vibes from this area, dude. I'm a fan. Excuse me. I'm sorry, but you know how it is. It's like you're a potential threat, and as much as I would like to have you as my friends, I don't think it's gonna work like that. Are you... You're a dead guy. Okay, just check. You ragdolled already. All right, we found some bullets. We're in the labyrinth that we were looking at from above, which is not wasted on me. I understand that we've done some traveling. one of these. Yes, even you. I know. I know the secrets to the souls. Come on. Nah, that was actually... Are you dead? I swear I didn't kill this one. Alright, so there's some pre-deads. There's some pre-dead people here. And there's some that are very soon to be post-dead. It doesn't really make sense, but just humor me. Every time that I look in the mirror, all these lines in my face getting clearer. Nope, AoE, get out of there. The past is gone. One every night from dusk till dawn. And that line makes a little more sense in this video game than I meant it to. Isn't that the way? Everybody's got the sacks and life to pay. Dude, I'm finding so much shit right now, I don't even know. I don't even know how to handle it. Where are we going? We're going to the big blue. It's a, what is this? Behind you. Don't freak me out like that, man. Fucking hate it. What is this? It's a gift. Summon defector. We've got a fucking NPC. Please, my friends, help me in this dark and desperate land. Resonates with another. Oh, baby, you don't have to put it like that. Has arrived. It's very nice to meet you, sir. How do I, yeah. Hunter's salutation, of course. Alrighty. Well, we've dreamed on enough. It's time to make that dream a reality. And just like that, the man is back in town. The boy's back in town. I'm really scared that, like, we're actually already in the boss chamber and the boss isn't through that door. It's actually this guy right here. I'm actually super scared that that is the case because this looks like a wide enough arena for it. You guys gotta realize, I'm still 100% blind playing this thing, so I don't know if that thing is like an actual beast that's gonna eat me alive, but I'm assuming by my old pal, which he's disappeared because even he's scared. Yeah, and the spirits and stuff. Okay, well, this was a short walk to the boss fight. I expected there to be one maybe a little bit farther in the future, but I guess it's time to get our ass kicked. Hello. Fine, sir. Oh, shit. It's a dog. It's an electric dog. Electric eyes. Yeah, this guy's gonna have some nasty AoE. I'm feeling like maybe fire. Do we have any fire? Our defector is like already here. I don't know what this beast blood pellet does. If it's a damage up. Jesus Christ, there's so many things happening on the screen. This guy's bushy tail is actually. I always consider it a success if we don't walk in and get totally smashed. So we've already done our due diligence. Excuse me. Yes, roast him. Roast him and toast him. That's what I should eat. Is there any way I can switch? Yeah. Ah, the roasting actually didn't do that much damage. Ow. Oh, baby. Ride the lightning. This is too much. Never knew that a boy like me would come to this. Yeah, that. Can I, you know, it's been a while since I've, like, actually hit him. Jesus Christ, he hurt me. Motherfucker. I just died in the talent tonight. Must have been something you said. Or possibly that you roasted me alive. I just died in your arms tonight. Excuse me. None of that hit at all. Get out of it. Go. Oh, God damn, the spidey senses. Alright. That seems like a good time to critical that guy, but we fucked it. So now it's just me and this lovely beast. Yeah, we fucked the timing up on that roll. And we paid for it. And he's going into, like, mode 2. Which I'm not a fan of. Maybe we should, like, start playing Lock. Alright. I can't see. Let's make sure we're all the way up on our health here. Let's just take it strategically. We're not going to be using much of our side instrument. A little range is not going to work. But we need to take our turn. It's a dance. It's a game. Make sure you take your turn. I'm probably going to die here. I don't understand what's happening. Get out of there. Pinocchio! You were too young for this world. Good lord. Well, upside being first time on the boss, nearly half health. I'm being very gracious to the to that, but okay. Well, let's come back in with a strategy, because that guy, first of all, first part of the strategy, drink some water. Second part of the strategy is to, like, fucking gussy this guy up with, like, maybe some like a happy face, like a McDonald's Happy Meal or like a Burger King crown or something, just to make the mood seem a little bit livelier. Third part of the strategy, we gotta see about upgrading our weapon, man. I mean, it's about time. Honestly, I want to say I might have been saving some shit so I could get, like, a better weapon. I've always wanted a massive-ass greatsword. I mean, I still can't find one. But, looks like, you know, maybe we just gotta do with what we got. And maybe not kill the people that are gonna be helping us.
Welcome home, good hunter.
Thank you very much. I've had a long day, honey. Desire? Let me tell you something. Things have not been
very
well.
Well, let me...
So we can level up. But very honestly, well, I'm still going by Dark Souls rules, which is it's much more important for you to level up your weapon as opposed to your anything we need to repair? Maybe this guy. Shoot. Well, let's look at fortification, because that's probably going to help us even better here. So we need twin bloodstone shards, 3 of them, and we have them. Sweet. So that might actually be all we need. Let's just upgrade our hunter's axe. And then as far as blood gem fortification, I know that we have. I'm just going to go through the list here real quick. I'm just looking at the numbers, not actually looking at the things. But we got the ones that boost our attack the most, which is the most important thing to me right now. So let's not go into either of those options, and let's get we've got a lot of blood echoes here. I think need to be popped. Let's honestly, I'm not a man to pussyfoot around, as some people say. Let's go fucking all out. That was a lot less than I was expecting. Excuse me. Is that all the blood echoes I have? I guess we just haven't earned it. Well, it should be enough at least for us, you know, I'm gonna stay positive even though I just got my ass kicked by a fucking Judas Priest dog. But it should be enough for us to do that, which I'm very happy about. Now we need 5 more twin bloodstone shards. That's actually a little ridiculous. As far as this, still a bit of a investment. And we don't even use it that much, so I'm going to stay away from doing that. You guys may not be okay with that, and it's understandable. Also, fortifying our weapon also fixed it in the process, which I'm very happy for. It makes sense. Everything makes sense. Where is the old guy that was here at the start of the game? I have no idea. Excuse me. Naked man. Do we have anything in storage that maybe we can get out? We've got bloodstones. Okay, well, it's not gonna work like the other games. If there's something in here that we can use, it'll let us use it immediately, I believe. So there's no point in really checking that. We do still have some more blood echoes, which I'm very happy about. Let's visit these guys first and see if maybe we can purchase some of those dual hand lantern. These are all the consumables. Fire paper might be really helpful to us, but it's very expensive actually. They'll let us buy bloodstone shards, but not the twin bloodstone shards. They'll let us buy the key to the Grand Cathedral's gates. They'll let us buy the Kirk Hammer. Interesting. I mean, I'm interested in something like this for sure. It's $3,000. Ludwig's holy blade. Holy shit. Wait a second. This is it. I found it. A trick weapon typically used by healing church. I'm so excited. Sorry. A trick weapon typically used by healing church hunters. It is said that the silver sword was employed by Ludwig, the first hunter of the church. When transformed, it combines with its sheath to form a great sword. We've done it. Ma, Pa, I know you aren't alive to hear this, but this is the most important day of my life. You spent your whole days making me be your man, and now I think I truly am the man that you wanted me to be. Oh, God. I'm so fucking happy. What can I do? There's nothing you can say. The healing church is a kind of pain. The workshop began with Ludwig and departed from old Gehrman's techniques to provide hunters with the means to hunt more terrifying beasts and perhaps things still worse. What's the downside? Well, the downside, I'll tell you. Thanks for asking me these questions. The downside is it's 20,000 blood echoes. We had to pop everything we had just to get 7,000. Now, honestly, this may seem like more than it really is. And the second downside is it starts with 100 attack. It doesn't seem to be doing a ton of damage. It might be silly to go to a new weapon this late in the early game, if that sentence makes sense, and lose out on the damage properties that we have on our Hunter's Axe already. Because our Hunter's Axe did start lower than this one. And it seems to me like the benefit, because our Kirk Hammer is such a slow, heavy weapon. I played it in the beta when they had it, in case anybody's wondering. So I'm very interested, or very excited in seeing what's going on with that. But otherwise, nothing of note. So 20,000 blood echoes. And I know I just said we had 7,000, but we're gonna have a lot less than that. Very well. Let me one, two. Well, I guess we can only really use 4,000 of them. That's quite a lot. This is our strength skill. We wanted to pump that. Blood tinge and arcane don't really matter to us because we're not really doing that kind of build. Vitality is just too low for me. We need to start pumping our health, I think, quite a bit. Farewell, good hunt. It's our lowest stat of the three stats that we care about, if that makes any sense. Makeshift. We do have a chalice for another dungeon, I think they are, but I'm not prepared. What? Awaken above ground? I don't know what this means. Fuck it. Cause it's a beautiful kind of pain. Wow, I'm really excited. We've found a lot. Oh. This is the unsafe. Okay, this is where we were before. Well, this makes sense. Well, let's give it one more round and let's see how this kind of takes us. Also, I'd love to, like, kill one of these guys, which is maybe easier said than done. We're gonna do one of those. Come at me, bro. I really want you to do it. I'm not gonna do the whole Joker thing I like to do whenever I say I want you to do it, but it comes into my mind every time, and I want you guys to know. Not okay. Come on. Just a taste. 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So he's got his little, okay, maybe we should have waited there. Honestly, that's the hardest thing about this game. There's absolutely no indication of when it's a combo attack or if it's just a single attack. Maybe I'm missing something, but like a lot of the times, these creatures have such a dynamic range of attacks that it's like they'll do one attack, and then they'll do the same attack, but then they'll also do follow-up attacks within that. So you, I don't really, there's nothing I can memorize. There's not really a lot of patterns. I really just have to keep holding back, maybe pick up these guys while we can. I thought they'd be stuck to this guy, but they're not. So, like, he does the one-arm attack. Now, after that, he would follow up with a kick, which he did there, I suppose. I don't know what that was, but I think it's just to kind of drag him towards him. Okay, so he does the... He's going to do an attack here. Excuse me, can you, like, prove my point, or you're just going to be an asshole about it? Okay. There's some attacks that we really just don't want to follow up with. Okay, so now he's in enraged mode. So enraged mode, which is just what I'm calling it. It's probably not what the developers are calling it. He's just going to do multiple attacks. Really, honestly, like, ought to at least maybe kill him before he gets to that point. Or, and in case you guys are getting a little dismayed about how much I'm dying here. Yes, it's not entirely on purpose. I would have killed that guy if I could. But I am also taking a little bit of a step back from my normal gameplay to kind of just analyze this guy's patterns, because it's going to help us out in the long run, I think. Also, I'd really like to know how many extra damage he gives me. And I'm glad to see that we're doing maybe at least a little more damage. Two. Come on, give me something else, man. I've learned your ways. I really haven't, but I feel like everybody said when Bloodborne came out that you want to be like as aggressive as possible. I don't think that's true, honestly. I think it's about taking opportunities when you can, which is honestly, it's what Dark Souls is about too. But you don't want to be, oh, that's a little ridiculous. But you want to be, you want to be cautious, I think. I think you want to be forward in your movements. Always got to think about location and that kind of stuff. But you also got to, like, you got to take your time and wait for... All of these enemies have these attacks that just kind of fucking ruin you. Maybe this place is, like, maybe a little too hard for my character at the moment, seeing as the amount of damage I'm taking. I mean, I'm probably using some old-ass armor, too, and all sorts of stuff. Yeah. I deserve that. I think we gotta understand maybe our iframes a little better than we do right now, because I gotta say, and let's try not to lose those blood points, but I don't really understand my iframes that well. I understand the best I can, but I feel like sometimes I get hit, and I'm not really expecting to get hit. They're not as forgiving as I think that maybe I thought that they were. As you think that I thought that you think that they thought they were. Was. Once. This is Blaze and Laser. Blazer. One hit is all it takes. I'm fighting Havel, but with the normal enemies of this level. Every time. Yo, let me, just, you know, bear with me. Give it one more go. And if we can slice and dice this guy, then at least I'll be able to see, like, how many of these guys we need to kill before we can get that greatsword, so we can get our juicy hands on at least a secondary weapon, if anything. No, you're not gonna sack me. And honestly, don't freak out. I was reading some tips on Bloodborne, not spoilers. But basically, one of them said that, like, you gotta use the parry as much as you can, because there's a lot of enemies in this game that are actually meant to be parried. Like, that's the way that they're meant to take down. Excuse me? Oh, I have my flamethrower on. I should probably change my gun. No. I was hoping I could interrupt that attack. But we gotta start exploring these parry windows, because I feel like that's gonna be the way to take down a lot of these guys. Specifically guys like this that do a ton of damage, but it looks like their attacks have a lot of leeway. Obviously, I'm hitting the same spot every time, and I'm not hitting it. But that's because I'm honestly super scared to be attacked by this guy. The right timing is a lot later than I keep doing it for. But honestly, I just kind of want to roast this guy now. There is the right timing. But you also get hit because of it. Honestly, but you also get all that health back. I think I've figured it out. The keys to the goddamn kingdom. Doesn't matter if you get hit, if you land, assuming that they don't kill you in one hit. Also, we have 4,000 souls. I completely missed the point of this. Honestly, I think they'll give around close to like 2,000 souls. If that's the case, we gotta kill 10 of these guys. Kill 10 of these guys, get a new weapon. 10 of these guys in a row without losing. It seems doable. Let's just take down this fucking pansy first. Am I right? Keys to the gut. Come on. Give me something to live for, baby. And we can even do it at range, too. Right? But we also have to account for when our shots are gonna reach him. There. See, I can even call my shots fucking Babe Ruth up in this. Babe Ruthless, am I right? Ha ha! That wasn't... Was that correct? Okay, well, maybe not quite. Babe Ruthless. Enough to be able to take down these enemies a little bit better. Yeah, 1368, so maybe a little less than I thought. So we're gonna need to kill a few of these guys. But we'll kill some other enemies along the way. Get a weapon. Oh! Don't do that to me! I don't deserve it! Yeah, are you slitting my throat? What's going on, dude? Stop it! Stop it! I'm too young to die! Am I dead? Completely? Yeah, I'm completely dead. So basically, I walked around the corner and got fucking gutted. I don't think I deserve that. I think that lots of things are unfair in life, you know? Let's not complain about it. Let's learn from it. That's my opinion anyway. I'm super happy we've got a direction. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. We're gonna get our souls back. We're gonna get ourselves a nice juicy weapon. We're gonna kick the shit out of Dark Beast Parl, was his name? Yeah, I appreciate it so much. If you guys like the video, make sure and give it a thumbs up. It always helps me out, especially in the smaller echelons of YouTube. If you haven't already, please subscribe. You'll get notified when more Bloodborne and other really cool Let's Play videos come up as well. As always, I'd like to thank you guys so much for dropping by to my channel, and I'll see you guys for the next Bloodborne.